Good day, it's Tony Fortunato from the technology firm, and today I'm going to walk you through a little bit of FTP client behavior. And what I want to prove is that not all FTP clients behave the same way, and please don't think that this applies only to literal FTP clients. This could be FTP embedded within an application that downloads a signature file or whatever, who knows. So this is actually very helpful to know. So the first thing we need to do is figure out how you want to intercept the traffic. Are you going to use a span, mirror, tap, hub, maybe just copy or capture right from the PC that you're on? Then you need to decide if you need a capture filter, you're going to filter on the MAC address, the IP address, the port number. So let's assume we have all of that out of the way. And then, of course, the other option would be if you don't want to capture any packets, maybe try to figure out the behavior by looking at server logs or application logs, that sort of thing. So here we go. From my server, my FTP server, what I did was something really sneaky. I put the maximum connections per IP to 1 and the number of connections to 1. And I'm trying to simulate that the server has run out of connections and what type of behavior the client might see from that. The big thing I try to stress here is you always ask yourself the question, how could you figure this out when you don't have direct physical access to the server, or the server doesn't really give you an error message, or the application is giving an error message, that sort of thing. So from the packets perspective, we see here it says too many connections for this IP address, that sort of thing, and it's a 421. And you might get a 5XX message as well, depending on where you actually get the error, at what point, and what kind of error. So let's see how the different applications report this very, very obvious problem. Chrome just says, hey, the web page is not available. And it says error connection reset. So this doesn't really help at all. There's actually down here that I didn't copy the whole screen, but down here there's a little details link on the Chrome. You click it, it says check your wires and all that kind of nonsense. So obviously that wasn't very helpful. Internet Explorer, when it runs out of connections, just literally throws up the authentication screen so you can log in again, which is kind of funny. It doesn't actually say there's an error as well. If we move to FileZilla, for example, it has a little console portion of the screen at the top part, and it actually tells you, too many connections for this IP address, please try again later. At least here I have an indication that there's a 421 and that there is an error that I could actually work with, whereas the other ones did not. WSFTP is a classic. Everybody somewhere is using this at some point. And it does the same thing. It says 421, too many connections for this IP address. Please try again later. And it says connection failed and the server's name was Church Hill. So there you go. Just some simple examples. What I'm trying to encourage you to do is to break things. Obviously, within some controls and within the safety of your network. Don't just go and bust production stuff. But try to pay attention to what errors you get, what types of errors the application reports or doesn't report. And that should help you out troubleshooting in the future. There you go. Have a good day. Bye for now.